Yeah, so today's topic is overview model in C++. Problem with current model, each time a header is included, the compiler must preprocessor and parse the text in that header every header it's included. This process must be repeated for each translation unit in the application, which involves huge amount of redundant work. That's why header is duplicated in several units and increase size of units. New model with modeler provide compiled modeler instead text file, and each unit just imports compiled model during linked instead duplicate header files. Let's show how to export declaration for model. Need use keyword export and export model of other elements of model like variable, function, class. Also you can export from newspaper. Import declaration include keyword import. You can import whole model, partition of model of header. About header, this future model is draft. That's why different compilers implemented import header in different way. But my idea is that compile should compile header like model. Start with simple model. In file hello world cpp, write export model and model name. Then export our function. In main cpp, write import hello world. It's just a very pretty example. How to build? GDC doesn't support in stable version this feature, but GDC has special branch for it. Need clone from Git repository, then config, build, and install. I provide my configuration and I choose to install GDC into user local GDC module. How to build? It's bash script. For enable module, need add flag for GDC F module TS. Also important send order in right order. First source should be export of module, then source that import module. during compilation, GDC generate folder gcm.cache. This folder store our compiled model and that was used when generate compile main cpp file. About clang. For clang need add flag too. But clang requires extension cppm for files that has export module. That's why I make copy. Next, generate compiled module. Yeah, and then generate object file for module. And next, generate object file. And next, use generated object file when compiled main in executed file hello world. Go to Visual Studio. Visual Studio same like in Clang, need compile our model. Then generate object file, then generate object file for main and use all object files when generate executed file. Model can have interface and implementation unit like header and source file or like declaration and implementation. In Hello World CPM file, we just use declaration. And in Hello World CPP, we use implementation and use just keyword model. This means like we implement some function of model. And main CPP when we import model without any changes. Unfortunately, GDC doesn't support interface unit. That's why we can compile just in Clang and Visual Studio. So first we compile CPM for generate our compiled module, and next we generate object file for our implementation and for main.cpp, and then use all object file for generate executed file. In Visual Studio, pretty similar. We generate object file for our module, then for implementation of our model and file when we imported model. And then we use all object files when we generate executed file. Model can has a partition. You can split model to several parts and import whole model or some part. For example, we have model speech and we separate to English and Spanish, and in two files we implemented each part of model, and then we imported whole model, or we can import like speech English or speech Spanish. Model have some structure. First, it's global model fragment when we use preprocessor instruction, includes some other files. Then we write export model and name of our model. And then some import declaration. It can be an other model of some headers that support export model, and then declaration of model of some declaration variable, and it can be implementation too. I found some recommendation about naming this model. For example, we have a library with name libbuild. It's recommendation use namespace build and separate some part of this library using dot like build dot base dot build dot file system and other. Let's see what is supported. You can see that now all compilers support only named module. Other feature not implemented in all compilers. So some compilers support like module partitions, private mode fragments, name attachment, and next, because now it's just derived, and I hope it will be implemented soon. I also find some example of using module. It's like it's slide from some conference, and speaker provide example how model help for his project. So we see like lines after preprocessing was decreased, time of compilation was decreased too, and also it's big improvement for compiling time because we use just compiled model instead our header, and also if we change header we need precompile file that import if it is not changes like in comment or something else and something not important changing, because when we imported we just analyzed IST instead text file. Also you can find some information, additional information how it implemented in different compilers, GDC, Clang, Visual Studio, and also I recommend start watch video from some conference when speaker introduced to speak to models. So let's summarize. We discussed problem with current models that we have in headers files, what we will have improvement when we have models, some examples, model structure, and real example with using model. Do you have any questions?
Yes, thanks for the talk. You mentioned that some headers can be imported as modules. Are there any restrictions on that? Some conditions for headers to be able to be imported as modules?
Yeah, I understand. As I said, it's just draft, and other compilers implement in different way. My idea was like, we have some standard header like your stream, and goals to provide model. No, when we write import and your stream, it means like import model when we have implemented your stream library. No, I try to running with compiler, but it wasn't successful because some compiler different implemented different way. For example, Visual Studio implemented it like std dot your stream like it.
And I have another question. It's more related to build systems. Currently, we can feed CPP files list to build system, and it will compile them independently. In modules world, there are some dependencies on modules and other files. So it will be a user's responsibility to put them in the correct order, or build systems are planning to provide some help on that.
Yes, I know model only one build system support model. It's like B2. I tried with Make like in right model, but I have internal exception in GDC. That's why I didn't find any information that some build system will support just only B2, but I think maybe in Visual Studio it's like implemented like have internal implementation.
Oh yeah, it looks like we have just to wait until they implement this feature and see how it goes.
Yeah. No, as I know, example, in CMake, there's some branch for it, but it still doesn't implement it. So if you don't have any questions, thank you for your time. And if you will have questions, you can touch me anytime.